Hey there, all Photoshop lovers. Welcome to a new tutorial with PSD Box. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to show you how I made this manipulation in Photoshop. It's something really simple to do, and it's more like an exercise to show you how to integrate elements into a new background, because that's basically it. It's not really like a very complex manipulation. It's a simple tutorial, so even beginners can do it. I just want to show you how to integrate this spider that you see here realistically onto this background. And actually, if you really want to practice, what you can do is just use another background. The image that I got from for this tutorial is from pexels.com, which is a website that I use a lot to get especially background images and also some models. But you can try using your own background or just find something else there on Pexels and try to integrate this spider onto a new background and see how well you can do it. What you will see in this tutorial is how to use the blend if options. We'll use really simple masks, so don't really worry too much about that. And how to use styles and basically how to match colors and contrast. So that's why I said it's like a practice. And doing this will allow you to train your eye to judge how the contrast works, the color works, and how to match the color of a background or the style of a background onto your object that you're integrating into that background. So that being said, I include the links to this PSD file. You can download it for free on my website if you want to see how I made it, and you'll find the link there on the video description. And also, if you're into Photoshop, if you don't know how to use layers, layer styles, and that kind of things, I have also an express course, an introduction to Photoshop, which you can sign up for free. Also, in order to download this PSD file, you have to sign up, which is free. And I did this because I noticed lots of bots and lots of fake downloads, or I don't know how to call them, but they just cracked my server and just crashed everything. That's why I restricted the download. So if you really want to download this, you can sign up, it's free, and you will also have access to this Photoshop course, which again, it's free, it's about three or four hours long, and it just introduces you to the basics of Photoshop and image editing. That being said, hope you will enjoy it. If you're new to my channel, subscribe and hit that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new tutorial. I have I don't know how many videos now, maybe 200 here on YouTube, and I hope you'll enjoy it. So let's get started. So let's get started. By the way, you have everything on the resources folder. I'll include the link on the video description. If you're watching this from YouTube, you will be able to download the resources from there, and the PSD file will be linked on my website. So open this image, which I got from Pexels, and I will have to make it smaller, 2000 pixels in width, and I'll just add my spider, which I already have copied on the clipboard, because I want to go a little faster here, and I'll use a pretty big size. That way we can create this contrast in size on that man and the spider. And in order to blend this, I used calculations. Now, I already mentioned how to use this on other tutorials in the past, and today I'm gonna revisit that technique. So place the spider wherever you want to have it, and the first thing I want to do is use the blend if. So I'll just zoom in a little more, double click to open the layer styles, and just alt click this control on the blending options just to start and fade this the colors there. But let's do that later on. Let's first create the mask for the background, because we want these trees to be in front of the spider. So select the background, go to the channels, and select the blue layer. I think it's the one that works best. Yeah, blue and green. Actually, blue works better. Now go to image and choose calculations. Now, this is what the calculations do. Let me just move this down a little bit so you can see me better. What you do with calculations is you have source 1 and source 2. Basically, what you do is blend channels. So you can use any of the three channels and blend them together using a blend mode. That's essentially what it does. So you can use even layers from different documents. Like you see, I have two documents here. So I can use the spider one document and blend a channel from a different document. But this is not what we want. Let's stick with our document. So on source one, I'll select blue for the channel. And on source two, I'll use the same document. And I'll choose a different, obviously you can use both of them and try blend and multiply works kind of, well, it doesn't look bad. This one looks good, overlay. This one works even better. The objective here is to separate the elements that you want to have as a mask from their background. In my case, I want the trees to, I want to separate them from the sky there and as much as possible from this fog here. So I will blend blue with blue using different blend. Well, I'm just trying different blend modes here. Hard mix looks good, but if you zoom in, you will see that actually you'll create some really nasty halos, so which is not what I want. So probably I'll have linear light maybe. You could try obviously different blend modes, for example green and inverted if you like to. Maybe we have it better like this because we can see better the silhouettes. I will leave it like that just for the sake of this tutorial. And I will use this as a layer mask. Now, actually, this is already a layer mask. So if I control click, obviously it doesn't have to be really, really precise because we can use semi-transparencies here. So I control clicked this alpha one, go back to RGB, click layers, select my spider, reveal it, and create the layer mask. Now I have to invert it, and there you have it. Okay, so I have my trees in front. Obviously, we have to make some corrections here, but it works pretty well. Now, I will control click the spider itself, the thumbnail, because I want to, let's do the blend if thing. Let's see how that works. Now, I'll double click on the layer of the spider to open the layer styles, and on the blending options, go here to the bottom and where it says blend if underlying layer, press Alt or Option on Mac and click this to split it and move it to about 100. But actually this is what it does, it's going to blend this even more, which is not exactly what I want. But anyway, let's leave it like that and use this layer mask to paint this out. I just want this trees to be in front of it and this ones. So what I will do is control click or command click the spider and start removing stuff from here using white. I'm using the white brush. I will leave it like that now. Of course, now we have the physical part integrated in here. We still have to fix the light on the trees, and the way we do that is create a new layer on top, control click the layer mask to select it, and on this new layer mask, just select sample a color, on this new layer which I created, I will paint with the brush tool, but these marching ants are kind of bothering me, so I'll press command H or control H. And on this new layer, I'll paint with that. I have to invert the layer masks. You see, it's just painting outside of it. So go to select, inverse. And now I'm painting on that part over there. Press control H or command H to hide the selection. And just use about 50 and 30 for the brush, opacity and flow. And I just want to darken those parts there like that. Okay, let's deal with the color of the spider now. I will use layer styles again, so double click on the layer spider on the spider layer, and I will use a couple of color overlays. I already have the color set here because I already used this, but basically what I did is I just sampled a color from here and I used something similar to the background. In my case, this brown tone. Use the color blend mode. This is just to remove some color from the spider because it was too colorful, it was too red, and that way I add some of this tone on the spider as well as desaturate it a little bit, and then add a second color overlay with the same tone, so sample it from there, something like a medium, like an average color that you see here on the background. And this time we'll choose lighten. Now, actually I will sample from here because I want to create like this sort of misty effect, and use lighten and now play with the opacity to integrate this like that. The lighten blend mode, what it does is it just adds the tone that you have sampled here to any color, or yeah, to any color that is darker than itself, that the one that is sampled. So if I sample from here, even if I increase the opacity to 100%, it's just only going to affect this really dark tones, because this tone is actually really dark. So if I sample from here, everything that is brighter than the color that I sample will not be affected. Only the ones that are darker than the one that I sample. So with the opacity, I can do something like that. Probably with the first one, I'll increase the color. Like so, and that's basically it. That's how I integrated this spider. Of course, we can add more stuff in here to make it look better. You can create a new layer, set it on screen maybe, sample a color from there, and actually I added a glow of light right over there. And the way I did that is with this new layer, let's use an opacity and flow of 100%, use a color something like that, maybe more towards yellow, and make a click there, and then use something brighter, maybe something a little more yellow, and a second click over there. And then I added that warrior, which I will not add because it's really simple, just add something there and that's it. Also, I made some shadows on the spider, new layer clipped to the spider, and I think I set it on soft light. Anyways, you'll have the PSD file, so you can take a look at how I made it. But really quick, I actually use this as a dodge and burn, because I have this on soft light, so if I use something really dark, I can darken the whole thing. Or you can use overlay if you want like a stronger effect. And let me just use 50 and 30 for the opacity on the brush, and just darken parts that are like opposite to the light or stuff like that, and just really quickly paint around here. And then with something brighter, you can actually brighten some of the highlights with the brush, not with the clone stamp. See that? So you can create like highlights, especially here on the eyes, over there. You can also enhance the eyes using a color dodge blend mode on a new layer, and let's just zoom in a little bit and paint over the eyes like so. And maybe something even more red could work, something like that. Also, I could select only the eyes using maybe the color range and just change the color of the eyes. Let me just show you how you can do that if you want to do it. So select the spider layer, go to select color range, and just click on the eyes. You can see it's going to isolate them right over here. I don't know if you can see it on the video, but anyways, it's going to make a selection out of that. And now you can use a hue saturation as a clipping mask and just change the color of the eyes. Well, I don't know, maybe yellow looks better. Okay, and just to finish it off, I'll create a couple of adjustments, a color lookup, and these are some adjustments. For I think I used the fine portrait navy to have this navy bluish look on it. This is from a pack of LUT presets, which are for members only. So if you're a premium member on PSD Box, you can download, I don't know, have like 5 or 6 packs with 10 presets on each pack, and can create this sort of creative stuff here. And then I added another one, another color lookup, and I'll put a link to those, to these packs, if you wanna download them. Well, if you wanna see what they do. And then I have the LUT Mix Russian. Yeah, this one. It's also creates this sort of tone in here. But you can actually use any preset you like. You can use gradient maps or any other preset that you have. And this one creates this sort of greenish, toxic effect on it. This one you can download it for free. I'll add a link on to it on the video description. So that's how I created this simple manipulation. I really want to see what you add. Of course, I added some flying birds as well. You can add as many details as you want. Just let your imagination go wild and add details. Let me just really quickly add those flying birds right over there with the higher opacity and flow. Just one click there and I have those birds there. So that's all, really simple. I hope you enjoyed it. And again, if you create something nice, you can add this, for example, like on a city or something like that. Just use the hashtag PSDBox and credit me if you feel like, so other people can find this and give it a try. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope to see you on the next tutorial.